For those of you who watched the video on Patreon about Queen Astrid of Belgium, about the sunken car of hers in this lake, and I did say I was going to head out there and do an EVP session. Well, here we are. There is the chapel in memory of where she died. Unfortunately, and I'll let you hear a bit of this before I turn the sound down, they're doing work here and it's so noisy. It's just impossible to do an EVP session, but I did get out here. At least I made the effort, and there is the chapel. Anyway, onwards and upwards, because while we're here, we're going to check out a beautiful little town where the rich Swiss live, and it's a spot on earth that Mark Twain declared as the most charming place he had ever lived. And here it is. The place is called Vegas. And I've heard that the house prices here are very expensive. It's for the richies. But obviously back when Mark Twain was living here, it was probably a lot cheaper. Maybe his fame made it more expensive. But it really is beautiful. It's a lakeside town. And I can see why it is a desirable area to live in. Very nice. The Schweizerhof Hotel. Hotels are very expensive too. My mother-in-law has stayed here a few times. Cost you an arm and a leg. For those rich people out there, it's no problem. Look at this old place. I wonder what they're doing, whether they're just sort of letting it rot slowly. It's obviously been an old hotel originally. It just seems to be empty now. And it's a gorgeous day. Wonderful. Oh, Beau Rivage. I do like that name. I do like that name. Here we are. This is the Beau Rivage Beer Garden, or Dinner Garden, or Lunch Garden, right on the lake. God, it must be nice to have money, eh? Must be nice to have money. Look, it's really, it's sparkling clear. Absolutely. It's well manicured too. And here we are, Mr. Twain. This is a memorial stone to Mark Twain. And to the right there, it's inscripted that he declared it the most charming place he's ever lived. I wonder what it looked like when he was here. Would have been a lot different. But the lake would have looked pretty much the same. Isn't that lovely? Isn't that lovely? Yeah. I don't know what, if you guys anywhere in the world are still having lockdowns and stuff, but at least we can get outdoors. Thank God for that. Drive you nuts if you have to be stuck in all the time. Wouldn't it be fantastic to have a boat, a nice yacht or something, right out in the middle of the lake there? Wonderful. Or just sitting at the Beau Rivage Beer Garden, watching the slow river life go by. Could do that for a few hours. But we're going to continue our journey because I want to show you a town that I filmed a couple of months back, actually. It's not recent. I just never had the chance to upload it. But it's a charming town. It really has a nice vibe. So we'll say goodbye to Vegas. I know this is not for everyone. I know some people just like the historical features, but I know there's others who like to travel vicariously through my videos and who love to see a bit of Switzerland. So for you guys out there, this is for you. And here I am, stuck in traffic on the way home. Stuck in traffic in the city of Zurich. Pain in the butt, really. Let's get out of here. Here we are. This is this lovely town, Bremgarten. I like it. I like it. Yes, when I filmed this, it was still during the lockdown, so a lot of the shops are closed, so there's not much happening, which I don't mind. It means I can film a lot easier without bumping into people. Few people out, though. Rather chilly. You see this place here? If I had the money, I would buy this, and I would, you know, sort of refurbish the outside, keeping its antiquity, but inside I would make some lovely bachelor units or studio flats. That could be really trendy. There's a lot of students in this town. Make it affordable for them, but very smart, because I think this place is trendy. It's gonna It's going to go places, most definitely. Most definitely. Someone's going to grab that building. Look at that, the Stadthof Hotel. Isn't that wonderful? You really have a feel of how it was back in the old days, and it's not hard to imagine because the town still looks ancient. Love it. Absolutely love it. Cobblestone streets, the windy roads. Wonderful. Before Wi-Fi, before the internet, before Sony Walkmans, before cars even. Yes, give me a time machine and I will win the lotto. I'm talking crap. I don't know what to say. So, well, I hope you enjoyed the journey. I'm trying to think if we've got anything else to show you. Yes, I do. I can show you Oddette feeding the goats where we live. What a shame they don't have sort of scratch and sniff, sort of like a smell-o-rama, because they're quite aromatic, these goats. And not in a pleasant way. But they are sweet. Look at the baby ones. Oh, beautiful. I used to be a city person. Hard to imagine now. I couldn't go back to it. I do love the country. Really do. Even the smells. Even the smells. He's saying, thank you, Oddette. Thank you. Now, I wanted to show you something before we head off. I bought this some years back. It's very rare. It's about 1900, so it's about 120 years old. It's a German tin shield, and it says here is for sale only, pure, guaranteed, prima American petroleum. And this sign is extremely rare. I've only saw another one in an auction several years ago. I haven't seen one since. So really rare. And also there was a porcelain version, which I've only seen once, and that is in a video that I took years ago of that Time Capsule General Store. I'll show you the clip now where you can see the porcelain one, slightly different colouring. Extremely rare. I'd love to get my hands on that, I tell you. But I have, anyway, the tin version, and I'm restoring it here, as you can see. Normally, with old shields, I wouldn't touch them. I love the patina, but this one, the top half, was totally gone. There was no paint left. It was just rust, surface rust. So don't judge it yet. I'll show you when it is finished. I'm going to sort of work back that bright yellow, take it back and add some patina once I've hand-colored all the letters, which I'm going through now. I wanted to save it, basically. I wanted to save it. I want to see it brought back to life again. I know it's no longer going to be original, but it'll look original when it's finished. Wait till you see. It's going to look original with patina. Before I go, I want to show you something I'm going to highlight on another video, and it's a book of hand-painted women's fashions from the 1960s, all done by this young woman called Anna Marie. And I'll just show you a quick few shots now to give you a taste of it. I found it in a junk store. I don't like this junk store. I don't like the people who run it. A couple of greedy, ignorant women, but I hadn't been back for a long time. I thought I'd go back, and I saw this album. First of all, it was the album of the house. I didn't make the connection of actually Anna Marie's house, which doesn't exist anymore in Zurich. It's been pulled down. I did a bit of research. But she carefully, she really was a historian herself, she carefully took photographs of the exterior and the interior of her house, which I'll also feature. Well, I bought that first, and I came back the next day to see if there was anything else. And then I found the fashion album, all hand paint. I thought, wow, that is fabulous. And of course, these two women, of course, saw dollar signs, and they've put the price up immediately, which is their modus operandi. If they notice that you're interested in something, like I used to go and buy old 1930s photo frames there, you know, family photos that people chuck out. They were affordable. As soon as they realized I was buying them, they put the price up tenfold. So I stopped buying them, stopped going there. Anyway, I paid the extra for this album. I thought, yeah, this is quite special. And I didn't really connect the two at the time, apart from the name. And then I realized it was the same person. This Anna Marie had designed this book. And I do remember there had been other photo albums, so I went back the next day and I found a photo album that she had kept as a child, and it was fully detailed of all the hotels that they went to, the menu cards from the hotels, things like that. And I thought, I'll grab that and I'll make a video for my viewers on YouTube. The album has no intrinsic value, really. No one else would be interested in it. I went up to the counter and she's like, whacked the price up again tenfold. And I said, you know what? Keep it. It's a shame, my viewers, but I'm not going to bow to such extortion. No way. No way. I do have these two beautiful items, which I'll show you. And I've got some amazing treasures also to show you in the future. Things that I have found on my junk store journeys, which I haven't shared with you yet. On that note, I will wish you a most pleasant day. God bless and goodbye.